Hi, welcome to What the Flick. I'm Christy. This is Matt. This is Alonzo. We're going to talk about a great little movie called What We Do in the Shadows, which came out in limited release a couple weeks ago, but goes wider soon.
Yes, yes. So. This is a film out of New Zealand. It is a mockumentary about a trio, actually a quartet of vampires that are renting a house. They are flatmates. They are scraping by. They have problems that any flatmates would have. This mockumentary crew is following them around, and it really, this is the Spinal Tap of vampire movies. Let's watch the clip.
We're gonna have a little flat meeting in the kitchen.
Okay.
When you get the four vampires in a flat, obviously there's going to be a lot of tension.
One of the unfortunate things about not having a reflection is you don't know exactly what you look like.
I go for a look which I call dead but delicious.
Hello, ladies.
Vladislav used to be extremely powerful.
He would kill anybody, burning everything. It's totally great.
This is my torture chamber.
Great orgies. 20, 30 women.
He could hypnotize crowds of people.
The neighbors can see you flying around. You want to draw attention to this house, hmm?
You've got a whole documentary crew following you around.
I came to this country for love.
Some people freak out a bit about the age difference. They think, what's this 96-year-old lady doing with a guy four times her age? They can call me cradle snatcher, who cares?
A private secret society, mate. You don't go bringing your bloody cameras into everything.
You will not eat the camera guy. Maybe one camera guy.
I'm not talking about bloody hair.
The thing that's so great with this movie is it's two genres that have been totally overdone.
Yes, like, you thought you never wanted to see again.
The big documentary and a vampire movie, and they mash them up, make them something totally different and hilarious and great.
Yeah, and it's kind of sweet. This is a movie that is, you know, like Spinal Tap, there's an affection for the characters here. It really, you kind of want to see them do okay. And as much as you see their foibles, you know, there's an early scene where they're talking about their chores, and one of them says to one of the guys, you're behind on the dishes. You're 5 years behind.
There's
this mountain of blood encrusted dishes.
We'll do my dishes.
There's a lot of moments like that are very funny. You know, a lot of things, they capture what would be the day-to-day minutia of being a vampire and kind of the shit that you would have to realistically deal with. And it does that in a very funny way. And stuff, as you think about it, you'd probably see coming, but it's executed really well. Right. I like this movie a lot.
It's so funny and so just kind of disarming. It's co-directed by Taika Waititi and Jemaine Clement, who are two of the main forces behind Flight of the Conchords. And it has that same kind of like low-key but oddball humor that show had. The two of them actually previously collaborated on a film that I didn't like all that much called Eagle versus Shark.
I say Eagle versus Shark, but I don't remember it very well.
It's very, you could kind of tell it's trying to be Napoleon Dynamite, uh-huh. You know, and I didn't find it appealing. But this time I think they really hit on a tone that really works. There's just this sort of absurd humor where like there's a human who gets turned into a vampire, mm-hmm. and does it all wrong, just goes around going, "Hey, I'm a vampire, woo," you know. And then he has a friend named Stu, who's like an IT guy, who's just right. really unassuming, but everybody loves Stu.
Right.
Like, they adore
Stu's
Stu.
Human.
Yeah, right. You know.
And
then there's the whole thing with the werewolves, which was really funny.
Yeah, it was very clever.
They're like a 12-step group or something, you know.
I can smell werewolves.
Why don't you girls smell your own crotches, huh?
Bitch.
Go swear.
What are we?
Werewolves, not swears.
Take it, sis.
Yeah, right.
We're werewolves, not swearwolves.
Exactly, right, right. You know, and the alpha is played by Rhys Darby from Flight of the Conchords. It's, yeah, I mean, I didn't think I was wanting to see either a vampire movie or a mockumentary anytime for the next 5 years.
Right.
And boy, put them together and it really works.
It's very consistent, too, in terms of tone. Like, they know what their sweet spot is and they stay in it and they hit it the whole way through. It's only, like, what, 80 minutes long?
Yeah.
It's super short.
And sweet.
And it seems like it's a one-joke movie, and it is a one-joke movie. But they find so many different little avenues into that joke that you're never bored. It never feels repetitive. It goes by really quickly. Yeah, just so many great lines, great details. So I don't even know where to find it right now. Where is it right now?
I think it's playing in New York and L.A., and then it's...
And it's expanded to a few other cities.
It's on VOD.
And
I don't think it's
on VOD yet. On March 6th, it's going to expand to more cities, mm-hmm. and it'll probably be on VOD relatively quickly.
Okay. So it's in some area of distribution,
it.
You know. But by all means, look for it. It's
one of the better vampire movies. And we've had some really good ones in the last 2 or 3 years.
Only Lovers Left Alive.
Only Lovers Left Alive. Girl Walks Home Alone.
Right.
This one is as good as those. It's really fun. And really kind of surprisingly sweet.
Now I remember. What I like is that also each of the characters is sort of a different brand of vampire. You have your sort of Vlad the Impaler, like army guy. You have your, 18th century European fop. You have your sort of new romantic, your old school Nosferatu.
Right.
it plays around with the conventions of it, but it doesn't sort of clobber you on the head with. It's clever. It's not too preciously clever about the genre. It's just like this sort of... Yeah, it ultimately does boil down to, it's your century to do the dishes.
Right.
You know?
And also, there are a lot of pop culture references in this, but I don't feel like they wedge them in to seem hip. Quite the opposite. It's like the awkward ways in which these vampires are trying to assimilate.
Right. They're still talking about the Lost
modern
Boys.
Modern day pop culture. And so it's just it's another clever way that they use a thing that we are accustomed to when they find a different avenue into it. So what are our numbers then, please?
I gave it a 9. I was thoroughly delighted throughout.
Yeah, I gave it a 9 as well.
I also gave it a 9 just for consistency. So our average is a 9. And where is it?
94% on the tomato meter.
Nice.
Yeah, so go find it.